Hi everybody and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are on the way to see how to run Drive Driving on your PC. Here you can watch it on your screen. We will be able to efficiently download and install Dr. Driving so that we can play the game on a Windows computer using our gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. Then without further ado, let's go my friends. Before anything else mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, because I provided the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our Usitility site, where we have a thorough description on just how to download Dr. Driving on PC. We scroll down a little bit as well as click the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we arrive here on the website of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we will run to get access to this game Dr. Driving on PC. It is now obvious that we get several advantages of preferring this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and the list goes on. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Dr. Driving by clicking on this button Download Dr. Driving on PC that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We answered yes. I reduce the internet browser to start to see the installer better. The installation software is quite simple. It is made up of two choices, install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path genuinely does. We simply click it. Therefore, we observe that we display here the path where your emulator is going to be set up. If we would like to change for better this directory, we have to click on the Browse button. Therefore, we select another folder and install the emulator precisely where we wish. I am going to keep it as it is. Then, I click on Back. And therefore, I simply click Install. At this point, before beginning setting up the emulator, it is also possible that it'll present us one or two software deals to install on our desktop or laptop. As I do not wish to have any of these software programs, I only click many times on the reject button. Great! The setup commences and it will carry on together with the download of those MB that are shown on the screen. The time you save it on your hard disk, it is likely to be a little more or less MB. The data transfer speed may go faster or slower, determined by your connection and depending on the efficiency of the emulator servers. Right away they are running superbly fast. The download is finished, and so straight away it proceeds with the setup step. The installation requires more or less time according to the power of your personal computer. The more efficient it really is, the faster the setup time and/or vice versa. If we join the download and installation step, it usually takes a considerably long time, so have patience. It has now finished on my side. At this point, the emulator happens to be started instantly. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator will be launched for the first time. The reality is the emulator was already started, here it is for the first time. Not to mention LD Store is immediately started, which is a sort of Google Play. This is simply not the optimal solution to install the game, and therefore I don't advise using it, since generally the LD Store sets up an out-of-date version of the video game. I'll present to you the way to set up the video game utilizing the Google Play, therefore I recommend you to do it this way. The very first thing we are required to begin doing is to navigate to the computer's desktop by hitting this icon that I'm pointing out in green. Before we continue on, as you can observe, it created two software icons right here on the PC desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer app icon is the one we are considering. The moment we choose to launch Dr. Driving on our laptop or computer, we double-click on this particular software icon and therefore use the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon is not related to multiplayer or even anything at all like this. Not surprisingly, it is an app icon that we will almost certainly never ever make use of. We should perform the next phase, that is a requirement, and that's to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To achieve this we will browse there to System Apps, we click. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is started. In this case we need to log on. At present as soon as we're there, we have to begin doing the next phase which is compulsory. So we simply click on, Sign In. At this point it shows, Checking Info. It might from time to time get blocked in, Checking Info, and this doesn't continue. In that case, you could attempt to log in after a couple of hours, but it will surely most likely be sorted out. At this point, we will type our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email and its related password. For example, you may use the same exact email you use at the moment in your own YouTube account. Thus, I am going to provide my information and I'll revisit as soon as I have accomplished it. That's all. Details typed. This is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We must accept all of them by hitting, I agree. After that, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could let it checked and it'll generate a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize that option if you desire. We just click on accept. From now Google Play is started by default and automatically. Whenever the Google Play isn't started by default and you do not know how to run it manually, I explain how to do it now. The very first thing is to navigate to the emulator desktop by pressing this software icon designated in green. At this time we head to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Okay, we are right within Google Play. What we are going to accomplish will be browse here to search for apps and games. Then we are going to research Dr. Driving. Generally there we get it, we are going to select the first result. At this point we get the Android game. Why don't we simply click there on the install option that I'm just highlighting now in green. This will begin the software setup. At this point it would download on your desktop or laptop and set up the Android game. It may take a little while or it could possibly be almost immediate. This all is determined on the connection to the web. It's already completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing the following button that I'm presenting in green, so that you can use Dr. Driving for the first time. I am by then on the emulator desktop. And then we are preparing to just click on that fresh Dr. Driving icon which has been created. That video game is started for the first time. Now there we get it, I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the sound level of the emulator. It's here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we are not going to depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we could switch on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. That is actually the very first one. We just click on this particular software icon that I'm pointing out in green. Then the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Supposing that we wish to play the video game using all the screen, we press on this particular software icon. And we'd without a doubt be enjoying the game app in full screen setting. To stop the full screen setting, push the F11 key. And we'd just be in regular computer screen mode. From now, I am starting to explain you the computer keyboard mapping that is actually quite cool. This means we will certainly be capable to play the video game a lot more easily. The first point is to click on this app icon. It's now time to complete the required configuration settings. I am about to keep the normal configuration, however if you like to modify this, you can also do so with no problem. I have this chance to say that in some cases, when commencing the video game a black screen occurs. If this is so and you notice the black screen and that emulator doesn't initiate, I propose a plausible alternative. We should browse here, to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator options, in the advanced selection we get a range of resolutions. That is the image resolution that we have at the moment chosen as favorite choice and so we should select any of these additional resolutions, for instance that one below. We opt for it and consequently click on save. It may require us to restart your emulator and once restarted, most probably the emulator will commence and your black screen will vanish entirely. As you can notice, the emulator is totally in our own language. In some cases it occurs that the emulator is started in the erroneous language, for example, in Chinese language. So to place it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. So there throughout additional options, we just click on the language drop down. We may go with the language we want, Spanish, Chinese, and so on. As soon as the language is selected, we could save, the emulator would reboot, along with the game, the next time we run it, will as well be in the chosen language. At this time, there's another point that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google saying that a brand new device has been linked to this Google account. It is going to question us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. Of course, we must not be troubled, considering that the emulator is emulating a Google Android electronic device. And then to discover which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we go here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. So we go here to the, model, selection. And right here we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it, folks, so much for my training. I anticipate you enjoyed it, particularly that everyone found it handy. If that's the case, offer it a pleasant like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, concerns or suggestions. Let them in the comment field down below. You could also comment things on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams every once in a while. You get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of those online videos which are usually appearing on the screen and see you in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye.